Number 8, you must not discriminate unlawfully against any person. Number 9, you must be open and cooperative with your regulators, the AJK Bar Council. And last but not least, you must take reasonable steps to manage your practice competently in the fulfillment of your legal obligations. So these are basics, the basic 10 core duties of the lawyers. Being a lawyer, you should observe these duties. Now we come to the second part of the topic of the lecture, the conduct of a lawyer. And in the first part, we will discuss about your conduct with regard to court, you and the court. So the first thing about the court would be not misleading the court. We rarely hear about this thing that not to mislead the court. But if few of us actually understand this, what is misleading? And along with this, you must take reasonable steps to avoid wasting of the court's time. So when you talk about misleading the court, what does it include? How we mislead the court? So the first thing you should know that you must not make submissions, representations, or any other statement which you know are untrue or misleading. So it's the responsibility of a lawyer that if he knows that a statement is not correct, or a submission he's going to make is not correct, is not legally correct or otherwise not correct, or any representation he is going to make before the Army Court, he must not do so. That's the prime responsibility. The other thing would be, which we normally practice, unfortunately, that you must not call witness to give evidence or put affidavits to the court which you know are untrue or misleading. So normally it happens that lawyers bring their witnesses in the court, knowing that the witness is not true, or placing the affidavits before the court, knowing the fact the affidavit is not true. So this is also a kind of misconduct. Another very important thing, under your duty towards the court, is never abuse your role being a lawyer. Because most of us do so, unfortunately. We abuse our role being a lawyer in the court. How it happens? The first thing we shouldn't do is that we must not make statements or ask questions merely to insult, humiliate, or annoy any witness or any other person. Normally when we do cross-examine, we commit these mistakes. We should not humiliate, we should not annoy, we should not insult any witness or any other person anymore. The second thing would be, you must not make a serious allegation against a witness. Again, it's a thing to understand that allegation, you can make allegation, but you have to give chance to the witness to answer that allegation, not a mere allegation, during the cross-examination. Number three, you must not put forward to the court a personal opinion of the facts or the law unless you are invited to require to do so by the court or by law. So another thing, very important thing. So we should not make any personal opinion about any fact or any law in the court unless and until court asks you to give your personal opinion about anything. So giving such an opinion is also a misconduct. Now I come to second part, behaving ethically. Of course, when we talk about the ethics, it's all about honesty, integrity, and independence. So, first thing about your integrity and honesty would be, you must not knowingly or recklessly mislead or attempt to mislead anyone. First part, it was about the court, not to mislead the court. Now about any person, because it's about your integrity, honesty. The second thing, you must not encourage a witness to give evidence which is misleading or untruthful. Normally it happens in our profession in this area, but that we encourage a witness to give evidence, a false evidence. This is highly unethical, this is highly unethical. The third one, you must not rehearse, practice, or coach a witness in respect of your evidence. So this is very much important that a lawyer shouldn't do this. Never rehearse, never practice, never coach a witness. Ask him to deliver his evidence, what is truth, nothing else. So giving a false evidence is indeed